Welcome to Hungry Squishy Brain's Learning Neighborhood. In this episode, we feature a rear loader garbage truck. We cover all of this, so be sure and watch until the end. Let's start with what we can see here. These two yellow panels here are the cart tippers. This blue bar here is the dumpster tipper. This panel here is the blade. This panel here is the upper panel. Here is a hydraulic cylinder that rotates the blade. Here is a hydraulic cylinder that rotates the dumpster tipper. Here comes a 64-gallon trash cart, full of white boxes. The cart gets hooked onto a cart tipper, and up it goes, dumping out its contents. Then the blade rotates downward, and scoops up the contents. This curved part here is called the hopper. Let's now hide this side panel. What can we identify here? This entire back area of this rear loader garbage truck is called the tailgate. This hydraulic cylinder here is what lifts up the tailgate. This hydraulic cylinder here is what moves up and down the upper panel. And this hydraulic cylinder is what rotates up the dumpster tipper. And these black rubber tubes, along with these metal tubes, are what contains the pressurized hydraulic fluid, which is used to power all of the movements that make this garbage truck function. All of the waste material is stored here, in the container, or box. And let's hide this inner panel, to reveal all the cool stuff going on here. The waste material is scooped up with only two movements. The upper panel slides up and down. And the blade rotates. Now let's hide the sidewall of the container, to reveal what's going on inside. This is the packer panel, or the eject panel. And here are the powerful hydraulic cylinders that push the packer panel backwards and forwards. The waste materials inside have to be compressed to create more space inside the box. Let's now hide a lot more of the garbage truck, so we can focus on the major moving parts for a better understanding of what's going on here. Here are the powerful hydraulic cylinders which push out and pull in the packer panel. These are telescopic, meaning, just like a telescope, there are multiple cylinders that compress into themselves. Here is the rotation of the blade. And here is the downward sliding of the upper panel. Then the blade rotates into the container. And the upper panel moves up. Here is the rotation of the cart tipper. Notice how there are two hooks on the cart tipper. The top hook goes into the top lip on the trash cart, and the bottom hook hooks around the horizontal bar on the trash cart. Here is a 4-yard capacity dumpster, full of white boxes, ready to be emptied out. How can you tell if a dumpster is meant for a rear loader garbage truck? Here on the sides, are these extensions? Dumpsters lifted with forks on a front loader garbage truck do not have these extensions. We are going to lift this dumpster up with the rear dumpster tilt bar. These bars here are what lock in the dumpster side extensions to control the dumpster's movements. And up the dumpster goes, dumping out its contents. Now for some cardboard boxes. Let's look closer at the movements. Here is a hydraulic cylinder, but this cylinder does not move this blade. This cylinder moves the upper panel. Here are the tubes that hold the pressurized hydraulic fluid. Inside the cylinder is the piston, which is the cylinder here, and the piston is moved by the piston rod, which is this here. The piston is a metal cylinder, and on it are two grooves, which hold rubber seals. It's the rubber seals that keep the fluid from leaking past the piston. Now imagine that the cylinder, on both ends of the piston, is always filled up with pressurized hydraulic fluid. Now imagine that one side of the cylinder is filled up with high-pressure fluid, and the other side is filled up with low-pressure fluid. Now imagine that the high-pressure side is shown here in purple, and the low-pressure side is shown here in yellow. So the high-pressure purple side will then push against the piston, and the piston will move towards the low-pressure yellow side. Then, when the controls are used, and switch the high pressure to the other side, as shown here with the color switching, the purple or high pressure side now presses the piston up. These are the two cylinders that rotate the blade. This cylinder moves the tailgate up and down. and there we are. This concludes looking at the major hydraulic movements of a rear loader garbage truck. We hope you have enjoyed learning with another informative and entertaining Hungry Squishy Brain creation. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to our channel and like our video, that helps us out a lot.
Hungry Squishy Brain.